Welcome to all of you. My name is Ashish Garg and today we are going to start our new topic, that is determinacy and the indeterminacy of the structure, and we will be going to see its previous year question that is being asked in the IAS examination or GATE examination. From this topic you will find that around one or two question is being asked in the around 3 years. So, as per IAS exam point of view, this topic is important, but its relation is more related to its next chapter, that is displacement method of analysis and the force method of analysis, because its application is directly there and we will see questions from there more as compared to here from directly determinacy and indeterminacy of structure. So starting with our chapter, determinacy and indeterminacy, we have to tell two things here. One, we have to find out the degree of static indeterminacy, and the other one is the degree of kinematic indeterminacy. So first we will start with the previous year questions that is being asked from the static indeterminacy. In this case, we have mainly three type of structure from which the question is usually being asked. These are frame, truss and beam. Frame, truss and beam. So we have to find out the degree of static indeterminacy of these three type of structure, and similarly we have to find out the kinematic indeterminacy for this structure. So starting with the questions that is being asked from the our frame, that is asked from the frame, degree of static indeterminacy for frames. Now the first question that is usually asked is why we use static indeterminacy or why we use kinematic indeterminacy. So static indeterminacy reflects on the unknown forces. It reflects on unknown forces, while the kinematic indeterminacy reflects on unknown displacement or unknown slope rotations. So its forces here mean movement also, unknown forces or movements, you can say unknown forces and movements. So this method is used when we have the degree of static indeterminacy is less than the degree of kinematic indeterminacy, that is ds less than dk, then only this method is used. So first thing, what is indeterminacy? That is when we are not able to solve our structure directly by equations of equilibrium. That means we can't solve our structure with equation of equilibrium, with equilibrium equations. So then we will use our indeterminacy properties and we will try to analyze structure by force methods or displacement method of analysis. So the first question that is being asked from the frame, let's see our first question of the day. From static indeterminacy you have given this frame and you have to tell its ds value. Find the value of static indeterminacy. This is very straightforward question. Now the another question that is usually asked is, you have given this structure say like this and you have given this hinge is provided inside the structure, and you have to tell the static indeterminacy of this structure. Now to find out the static indeterminacy, all you have to do is to cut the section, and when you cut the section you will see the three forces that is being acting over this structure. So these are the unknown forces. These are the unknown forces, and which gives us degree of static indeterminacy of this structure. So this is the question that is being asked in the previous year. By the way, degree of static indeterminacy is the number of member forces. It is the number of member forces and spot reaction. Number of member forces and spot reactions minus equation of minus number of equation of equilibrium. Number of equation of equilibrium. Equilibrium. So this is its formula from which we calculate the ds value, and we also know ds is equals to degree of static indeterminacy in case of internal degree of indeterminacy plus my external degree of indeterminacy. So this is how we can write degree of static indeterminacy. So if we see this structure, you can find the static indeterminacy in this particular case is 4. How it is that you will find that here you have 3 forces, here also you have 3 unknown forces like this, and from there you know you have the hinge. Hinge means you have bending moment at that point equals to 0. So you know one equilibrium condition further, and so you have 2 more equilibrium condition, and you will solve to get your degree of static indeterminacy. So this is the second question that is being asked from the frame. Now if we see our third question, that is being asked from the frame, in the IAS examination. The third question that is, you have given this again frame, but a link is provided at this point. Here you have given this link at this end and at this end. Say if this is A, B, C, D, E, F, G and H. Now you have a link given between point B and D and the E and G. You have to tell, find the degree of static indeterminacy. Try to solve this question by yourself. Once you read the concept, you can easily solve this question. I am here to provide you the insights, what are the different questions that is asked in the previous year. So this is another kind of question. Now if you see this, if you see another questions that is being asked are, you have given this structure like this. You have given a structure like this. You have to tell again degree of static indeterminacy for this structure. Now if I tell you the answer of this problem, its answer will be 5. You can see this easily. You will find out its answer equals to 5. Similarly, if we try to find out the value of ds here, degree of static indeterminacy here, you can see if you make a cut at this point and at this point, you will have 6 unknown forces. 6 unknown forces, but here you know reaction, if you write down here R, which is equals to 0. But we have here horizontal, we have here vertical reaction and also movement. Vertical reaction and the movement is acting over this part. Upon solving this, you know here you have 2 unknowns. You know that you have the 2 unknowns. After solution of this problem, you will find that its ds value comes out to be 1. Its ds value comes out to be 1 by solving this problem. Now we will see the another questions that is asked from the another kind of question that is asked from the frame. Now the fifth question is, you have given this frame, you have given this frame, Here you have given a hinge. You have to tell the degree of static inclination in this frame. So you can solve this by again applying the cuts in the frame, our frame, which is given as 3c minus r dash. You can solve your question of degree of frame by directly this formula. By directly from this formula, c is the number of cut required to open the structure. Number of cut required to open the structure. To open the structure. While r dash, or you can say r, it is the number of restraint required to make the structure rigid. Required to make structure rigid. So these are the questions that is being asked from the our frame. So these are the few questions that is being asked from the frame. Now some other examples, maybe you can see some other example here. Let's say this is our sixth example, in which you have given this frame like this, and you have given a support condition at this point. You have to tell the degree of static indeterminacy. So these are the some of the few questions that is being asked from this topic. Or you have also hinge at this point. Once you solve this problem, you will find that value of ds equals to 6. Value of ds comes out to be 6 in this case. So moving to our next topic, that is ds for truss, that is degree of static indeterminacy for trusses. So moving to our next topic, that is ds for truss member. We know in case of truss that they are the axial load carrying members, and to find out the unknown forces, we have this direct formula here, which is given as m plus r minus 2 times j, which is where m is number of members, r is the number of support reaction, where j is the number of joints. So with this formula, you can easily solve the value. You can easily find out the value of degree of static indeterminacy in case of truss. For example, the questions asked is, you have given this truss. Find the ds value for this truss. Ds value you have to find for this truss. You know ds equals to ds external plus ds internal. You can solve it by two ways, either by this formula, or you can calculate external indeterminacy and then internal indeterminacy, and by solving this you can calculate the value of degree of static indeterminacy. How we calculate DSI? We can calculate DSI by m minus 2j minus 3. Where DSE is given as r minus 3. If you add these two, you will get this formula. You will get above formula. But if this value, that is DSI value, equals to 0, then the question being asked in the previous year is, what is this condition called? If DSI value is positive, what is the condition called? And if DSI value is negative, what is that condition? So it is actually a perfect structure. This condition is called as perfect structure, while our positive scenario indicates the redundant structure, which means you do not know the forces. For example, in this case, if you calculate its degree of static indeterminacy, you will get your answer equals to 2, because you have two extra inclined surfaces which makes it indeterminate. So this is a redundant structure, and this is deficient structure. Deficient, or you can say this is also a mechanism. This is also called as mechanism. So these are some of the description of the structure, we can say. So this is our first kind of question that is being asked from our truss. Now if we see the another question that is being asked from the truss are, you have given this structure like this. Now you have to find the DS value. Find the DS value and comment about its stability. You can solve this question easily by this formula or by directly. How you can solve this? You know this is only axial loading member. So we will get this type of result. Once you solve this, you will find out that DS value comes out to be 0. So this structure is actually determinate structure. So this is the question that is asked in the previous year. Now if you see the third kind of question that is being asked from this topic is, you have given this structure and you have to tell the degree of static indeterminacy in this case. Find degree of static indeterminacy. Find the value of DS for this case. Once you solve this, you will find DS value here equals to 4. You will find the value of DS equals to 4. So this is the third question, third type of question that is being asked from the truss. These are some of the few questions that is being asked in the previous year from truss. Now we will going to see the previous year question of beam. So moving to our beam part, that is beam, degree of static indeterminacy for beam. Degree of static indeterminacy for beams. Now the basic of this particular part is, you know the cantilever structure is determinate one. This is our determinate structure. Now in case of beam, if you made any indeterminate structure into your cantilever structure by giving or assigning the moments and the reaction in that way. For example, you have given this structure where these loads are acting, and you have to tell the value of degree of static indeterminacy. Now if you make it into cantilever, how you can do so? You know this is the reaction that is being acting on this part. Similarly, we know that the reaction at this particular point is acting like this. Now you have two unknowns. But as the load is acting inclined, so there is a lateral reaction that is being provided by this beam here. Note here, you can point it out it here. This is equals to 0 because this is a roller support, while this is hinge support, so you will get here a horizontal reaction. So unknowns are 3. These are the unknowns. If this is A, B and C, this will be your RB, HB and RC. So you have three unknowns, and if you turn this 8 into cantilever, you will find that if you know the unknowns value, you can make this structure determinate. So its value or degree of static indeterminacy is equal to 3. Degree of static indeterminacy for this case 3. So question asked are, you have given this kind of assembly, these are hinges, this is known as axial load carrying members, axial load carrying member, and you have given this support condition again. You have given this support condition. If this is point A, B, C, and D, and E, you have to tell the degree of static indeterminacy. Find the value of static indeterminacy for this structure. So these are the questions, some of the questions that is being asked. If you see the third kind of question, from this part, you have given this structure where there is a hinge at this point, and this is also a fixed port. If this is point A, B, C and D, you have to tell the degree of static indeterminacy for this case. Now if you solve this, you actually find out that, assuming we have certain reaction acting at this point, say R or certain load, that is whose value is P over this beam section. Now once you solve this, you have this value and this value. From here you can easily find out reaction at point A and horizontal reaction at point A. And similarly, you know this is the actual axial load carrying member. You will get only reaction like this, and once you solve this, you will get this reaction and this reaction. So the degree of static indeterminacy for this structure is actually equals to 0. That is equals to 0. In this case, if you actually remove this part, you will get these three reactions. These three reactions. So here we have three unknowns, but we know the moment at this point is equals to 0. Moment at C equals to 0. So you have one compatibility equation, and here again you have two unknowns, that is RB and HB. So we have 3 plus 2, 5 unknown, and one equation of compatibility to make structure cantilever. So degree of static indeterminacy for this case is equals to 4. So these are the some of the questions that is being asked from the degree of static indeterminacy for beams. So I hope you understand the question that is being asked from the degree of static indeterminacy. I will be continuing this lecture for degree of kinematic indeterminacy in the next class.